deep safeties. Marshall in the white, the visitors. We are underway from Mountaineer Field. And it's going to be Devine at the 5-yard line. And he's hit hard as he's knocked down at the 24. Mark Rogers was back on the return for the Mountaineers, and that's where West Virginia will start first down after a 19-yard return. There's been so much talk about Pat White, 81 career touchdowns, third in Big East history. There are the completion numbers. Has a very tight spiral, the ball he throws. Last year, sixth in the Heisman voting. Arguably the top quarterback in college football, but his team trying to put some pieces together. They played for good moments in that loss at Colorado, but ended up losing in overtime. They did get the rushing game going. They'd like to do that, get back to the old West Virginia way of doing things. They're going to throw on first down. Alric Barnett, the receiver, across the 35. And he has a first down catch for the Mountaineers to the 37. 13 on the pickup on the first play.
Great block by Jock Sanders on that last play. Helped him get down the field.
Let's take a look at the guys up front. Mike Dent is a Remington watch list candidate at that center spot. He anchors him up front. Noel Devine, small back, explosive. He's tough to bring down. He's first team all conference candidate in the Big East. Good start for White, going to the air. Ball now at the 37-yard line. They send Jarrett Brown, who doubles as a backup quarterback, in motion. We'll see a lot of him today. Swing it out to Brown. Makes one man miss, not the second. And he's cut down right near the line of scrimmage. The Marshall defense, they're getting better up front. Ian Hoskins, a 3-year starter. It's his third position in his career. Brandon Burns, tall linebacker on the edge. He can really blow up a lot of plays on the toss sweeps. And in the secondary, they love the play of C.J. Spillman, preseason first team All-Conference USA. Here's a look at Albert McClellan. He's preseason first team All-Conference, who will, they hope, will be a factor after winning Conference Player of the Year honors 2 years ago. On second down and 11, straight ahead, it's Devine, breaks a tackle, and he squirts his way up to the 43-yard line, close to 5 yards. Spillman on the tackle for the Hurt.
And that's where the game is going to be won or lost up front, with Capers, Figner, Dent, Isdaner, and Stanchek. They'll not only protect Patrick White, but open up holes, hopefully, for West Virginia from their perspective. But you mentioned a little bit about McClellan. They will spy with McClellan on Pat White. You need someone to have accountable for number five, Patrick White.
Here's a look at the big guys up front. See Greg Isdaner, the 322-pound junior, and there's the center, Dent, 2-year starter at that spot. Pennsylvania native, third down. From the 43, White keeps it, has a first down midfield. He's into the secondary and down to the Hurt 42-yard line. So quick, Spillman, the free safety, finally got to him.
And one thing, Marshall has gone to the nickel package each and every time. You see that read spread option, he just cuts it back, sees the hole on the weak side, and just outstanding running by Patrick White, what he does best.
And his ability at 6'1", to just break away from people. From the 42-yard line, they'll go twin backs this time as White looks to the sideline for the play call. Offensive coordinator Jeff Mullen setting things up. Three receivers from the gun. White sets one across the middle. Catch made, and it's a first down grab. It's hauled in by Alric Arnett, the junior from Belgrade, Florida. He's a big target.
Yeah, he's 6'2", 195. His sixth grab, he does a deep square in and a nice throw by Patrick White. And the most important thing, Trey, is he ran right beyond the sticks, knows where the first down marker was. First down, West Virginia, and they have a nice drive going here, taking in the opening kickoff.
Arnett's first two college catches went for touchdowns against Villanova. Ball at the 27. West Virginia on the move. White looking good through the air in the early going. Marshall showing blitz now. Five in the box. Hand off Devine running left. And he gets 4 yards down to the 23-yard line. James Burks, the junior defensive tackle, on the stop. There's a look at Devine, just 5'8". His thing is he likes to outwork everybody. He thinks he can outwork the next guy, and small in stature, big in heart.
Well, you know, he's very, very strong, stronger than you think. He bench presses over 400 pounds, so don't get be surprised by his small stature.
Second and six. This time a single running back Devine to the left of White, and takes the shotgun snap. Here's Sanders. Sanders in the clear for a moment inside the 15, and he's down to the 12. Jock Sanders, a guy you've got to know where he is everywhere on the field. That's his 13th catch on the year. Mario Harvey on the tackle.
Throw a little bubble screen and right out to Jock Sanders, and they need someone to step up. Patrick White delivers the ball. Nice check on the edge there by the wide receiver, and just outstanding running. Good block as well downfield by Mike Dent coming from his center position. Nice drive by Patrick White. He has confidence right now.
Sanders with a 12-yard reception. He's their leading receiver as a sophomore. Eighth play of this drive. There's what they've done in the red zone. Very effective this year. They have not been good in third and short situations. Let's see on first down what they do. It's an end around to Sanders. Trying to get to the edge. He's to the five, and he's run out of bounds to the four-yard line. C.J. Spillman on the tackle. Will Johnson, the fullback, tight end, led the way with a good block.
He is very versatile. A converted fullback, number six, Will Johnson, now lines up as an H-back, fullback, or tight end. Good block right here. Just seals that outside, allowing Jock Sanders to get to the edge. Also on the edge, nice block by Ehrlich Arnett. Inside the five-yard line, they are banging on the door.
Second and three. They have Johnson in a slot to the right of White. Devine to his left. It's a handoff to Devine, trying to run wide. To the pylon, he's in. Touchdown, West Virginia. The stretch play, they went from one side of the field all the way to the other, and the Mountaineers strike first.
And Noel Devine, outstanding running along with Jock Sanders, but Patrick White has really managed this offense in the opening drive. Good blocking up front. You see there, inside handoff, a pull and kick out right there by the tackles. That's Figner with a good block for him, and Noel Devine into the breaking the scoring drought here in the opening drive.
His first rushing touchdown on the young season. They go 76 yards and 9 plays, and the extra point by McAfee is through there. Impressive drive for the Mountaineers, mixing run and pass effectively. Devine finds the end zone on the sweep. 7-0 home team. Seven nothing Mountaineers, four plays of 10 plus yards on a 76 yard drive to strike first. There's a look at it. Noel Devine capping it off with a touchdown run. Believe it or not, his first of the season. They have got the running game going at Colorado, and a good start on their opening series, mixing run and pass.
You know, he ran with very good vision on that last touchdown run, Trey, and that's something that comes with maturity. You know, as he came out of Florida, he had over 6,800 yards for his career, but he's running as a more mature running back.
McAfee to kick it away. Darius Marshall 3 yards deep for the Thundering Herd. Marshall following some blockers across the 30, and a nice return for Marshall. They'll start at the 33-yard line. 36 yards on that kickoff return. Marshall, a team playing with a lot of confidence, coming off a road victory at Southern Miss in rainy conditions, and they're hoping to keep the train rolling with a 3-1 record. Mark Kahn, the redshirt freshman, has been sensational. A poised quarterback, first-year guy, southpaw with a strong arm, and his numbers have been very good. He's been battle-tested the last couple games against Memphis and then Southern Miss. Single back is Marshall. They'll go three receivers to the bottom of the screen. And a penalty flag comes in before the snap of the football.
Layup game on the offense. 5-yard penalty, first down.
It's our lead referee, Gerard McGinn. Hostile environment. He saw it at the Rock at Southern Miss. As we look at the offensive line, Brian Leggett, 3-year starter. He moved to center this year after playing guard for this team the previous two seasons. Darius Marshall, 3 of 4 games, over 100 yards rushing. He needs to be a factor today. There's a look at Leggett, 283-pounder from Meridian, Mississippi. First down, 15 now. First snap, pass over the middle, and a catch made by the tailback Marshall, and he gets the yardage back and then a little bit more up to the 39. Defensively for West Virginia, Scooter Berry is their anchor up front. Playing the defensive end spot, he's also played tackle. Reed Williams, their inspirational leader, academic All-American, coming back from injury. And in the secondary, Ellis Langster may be playing next year at the next level. They really love him at the cornerback. There's a look at Williams. Missed the first two games of the season. Off-season shoulder surgery on both shoulders. Tough customer, and he's ready for this rivalry game. On second down, toss pitch, Marshall trying to cut it back. Guess who's there? Reed Williams for a loss of a yard, back to the 39.
Well, you know, he's a different, there's a different defense with number 47 in the lineup. He grew up on a farm throwing bales of hay. Now he's throwing running backs around, and he just comes in from his middle linebacker. It just feels playing off the block of 73 Tillman, and just, that was a picture book tackle.
Fiesta Bowl defensive MVP, 9 tackles in that big victory over Oklahoma. He'll bring it on every play. Third down from the 39. Initial series for Marshall. West Virginia took it 76 yards on their opening drive. Emmanuel Spann in motion. Can over the head of his intended receiver, the tight end Slate. Had a lot of mustard on that one. They'll have to punt it away.
And Slate was in single coverage with Reed Williams. And you see, he had a little time here, but just threw it a little too tall. I think it's over anxious, but Slate was certainly open. Had he caught that pass, turned up the field for a big gain, but now funny situation for Marshall. Good defensive effort by West Virginia.
Here's a look at Ellis Langster, the senior from Whistler, Alabama. They love his speed in the open field, doubling as a corner and as their punt returner. First year as their returner, had a 36-yard return against Colorado last week. The punt away by Case Whitehead, the freshman. Fumbles the football, Langster coughs it up, and Marshall might have it. Do they have it? They do, at the 6-yard.
This would help his confidence.
4 lost fumbles for Bill Stewart's team. They'll go 4 receivers, single back. Mark Cann trying to get him on the board. It's the tight end, Lee Smith. Flag is thrown. Smith fighting for the goal line. He's in, but there's a flag in the vicinity of the Marshall backfield. And it's coming back.
On the 73, 10-yard penalty, first down.
Ryan Tillman, number 73, the left tackle, may be the culprit for Marshall, which negates a touchdown, Lee Smith. But that was a good call. Loose screen to the tight end and shows that Marshall has a pair of tight ends capable of hurting any defense, Slate and Smith.
Tillman, a young kid. Their tackles are both redshirt freshmen. His first year on the field, didn't play last year. Hargrave Military Academy. Big error there, holding penalty all the way back to the 17 now. First and goal from that point. Trips right this time as they send the tight end Slate in motion. Pitch to the short side of the field, Marshall. Hit head on and knocked out of bounds. Big play by Ellis Langster, and they rave about this kid. The senior is a special one at the cornerback spot.
He originally signed with UAB. He lost 20 pounds in the offseason, helped his quickness, and this is a big time hit right here. Lowers his head and just knocks Marshall, stops him in his track. Good play by the cornerback, Ellis Langster.
Junior college All-American at Jones County out of Mississippi.
He was from Whistler, Alabama. A lot of Southern recruits on both these teams.
Can now and a second and goal from the 17. Changing up the play at the line with a couple receivers. Send a pass more in motion in front of him, and now a timeout's called. Snap of the football. Are they going to get the timeout called? They are. And they'll blow this play dead.
Marshall, the first charge, timeout of the half.
He turned around after calling the timeout, and the ball came back, but they get the timeout to talk it over. Cody Slate, one of the best tight ends in America, hoping to be a factor down near the goal line. Right now, Mountaineers up 7. Coming off his best game of victory at Southern Miss last week, facing a second and goal from the 17 for Marshall, trying to cash in after a punt return fumble off the hands of Ellis Langster. They were near the goal line. A penalty backs him up as they send Bryant Milligan in motion. Can setting up, firing for the corner, nobody there, and it's incomplete. Couple Mountaineers in the vicinity. Scooter Berry on the rush. Brandon Hogan was back there with Robert Sands, the two DBs closest to the ball.
There was a misread. The wide receiver just broke off of his route, and the closest person was a gold-shirted West Virginia Mountaineer. It's lucky they just got away with that, not interception.
Passmore, a guy that has 4.340 speed, and he's long at 6'3". Give him a chance here in the end zone.
Well, you know, he's the go-to guy, leads the nation with 26 grabs, and he is capable of a big play. You certainly have to think of number one in a situation like this.
We'll send Slate in motion to pass more side. There's a look at third downs. There's Slate in the corner, but it's over his head and incomplete. He was open, but Can missed him, had too much on the football.
Out and up, and Slate is a guy who's got great hands. He is a defensive nightmare, a matchup, big guy, 6'4", 220, runs very good. You see, he just comes off the run right there and straight down the field, just a little too long, and he wouldn't have caught up with that anyway, out of bounds. But big play opportunity there. Slate was wide open.
34-yard attempt for the guy we talked about in the open, Tyler Warner, the freshman from Parkersburg, West Virginia, 2 for 2 in rainy conditions last week at Southern Miss, trying to get him on the board, and the kick is through there. So Marshall cashes in off the fumbled punt. They only get three after the Lancaster fumble, but Warner delivers and stays perfect. Skew on special teams, leading to a Marshall field goal. Warner's kick. It will be Rogers at the 5-yard line. Hit hard, hit a second time at the 22, keeps his feet, and moves forward to the 23-yard line. White will go four receivers as they empty the backfield this time. Plenty of time. Throws to the sideline. The catch made by Tito Gonzalez, a senior. They'll say no catch now at the 30-yard line. His first incomplete pass. We're at Mountaineer Field in Morgantown, West Virginia. Rivalry game, eighth meeting all time between these rivals. Alongside Renee Nato on the field, Mark Martin. I'm Trey Bender. Glad you're with us. This is a rivalry that has heated up, especially this year with Marshall, a chance to go 4-1. West Virginia trying to get some of that mojo back. They're 1-2 after a tough loss in overtime to Colorado in their last game. Mountaineers scored on their first series. Second possession, screen, catch made by Jala, the senior from Greensboro, North Carolina. Nifty moves, and he's close to a first down at the 33-yard line. He's dangerous at that slot spot, his sixth catch of the year.
He's worked hard in the offseason. Very, very powerful guy. Good hands. I want you to watch this block by number 9 if you see it. Right here, this chop. Bang, right there. Takes out a Marshall player. Allows Jala to get up the field. So Jock Sanders catching, running, and now blocking. Good play by Jala and good throw by White.
Aaron Johnson, the strong safety on the tackle. Big front wall. Mike Dent, Istainer. They're both over 300 pounds. Figner has 9 straight starts to that right guard spot. Here's a end around, double reverse, and they fumble the football, and Marshall appears to have it at the 27. No, West Virginia gets it back. A double reverse, and it almost backfires. Capers, the right tackle, jumped on it.
Selfish Capers, former high school tight end, is in his blocking, and just a double reverse, not a very clean handoff. And White didn't hand it off, he just kind of threw it back there. It wasn't a very clean handoff, and Selfish Capers peeling back for a block happened to be in the right place at the right time.
Renee, Johnny Jones had that football for a moment, the defensive tackle, and could not control it, and Capers saves the football for the Mountaineers. Second down and 16 now. Single back this time for White. He'll run the football, gets a block across the 33, and he's cut down there. Maurice Kitchens, the middle linebacker, their leading tackler on the play.
White has that football IQ. He sees a lot of things that a normal runner or quarterback does not see. He's seen it all since his freshman season. You know, he's not a big guy, Trey. He's about 185 pounds, but very durable. He's taken some hits and carried the ball. And, you know, I like to think certainly at the next level next year, he'll get a long look-see as a quarterback. He's certainly a great athlete.
This has been a concern. You see it there, just 12 of 34 on third downs. And this is third and long, third and 9, just across the 33-yard line. Pressure coming. White zips one over the middle. Catch made short of the first down by Sanders as he's cut down by Aaron Johnson, the strong safety. And fourth down coming up. Let's go down to Mark with more on White.
Well, all the great ones do it, guys, and that is to improve. Pat White called college football's most dynamic player by today's two coaches, yet he knows there are ways to get better. The passing game was one such way. New offensive coordinator Jeff Ball and head coach Bill Stewart wanted to see more passing so White could also offset that tremendous running ability. And so far this season, the stats haven't been eye-popping, but they say he's doing all the things that he wants to do. And also this season, he's being a good big brother because younger brother Coley is also a member of the Mountaineer football program now, guys.
White, a great leader, great leadership qualities. McAfee under duress, gets that punt away, bounces inside the 20, and down at the 12-yard line. I think West Virginia thought there was some contact there. Esley Derville downs it, 48-yard punt. Span and Small were the deep safeties. And Bill Stewart's team will go on defense now.
Good pressure from the Thundering Herd.
Did this hit a Herd's player's foot on this play?
That's why you have to get away. Very close call here as when the ball is coming down, coaches tell their players to get out of the way if you're not going to catch it. And that was a very close call that could have been costly to the Thundering Herd.
Cannon Company will go to work, but before they do, we have a whistle. Stoppage play here from the 13-yard line.
Previous play is under review.
So they're going to take a look at this. Did it hit the Marshall player's foot? So it's West Virginia football. The ball was down by Derville at the 12. He could have let it hop inside the 5-yard line, but decided to grab it, thinking it did hit a Marshall player. Here it is.
Real close call. Great camera work as he's trying to get out of the way, and, boy, you just have to get away. That was Maxwell.
Chris Maxwell, yep.
And he's just blocking or just getting downfield, ready to block, and, you know, didn't know where the ball was coming from as McAfee was under great duress pressure.
So Bill Stewart hoping for a break here on special teams after his team fumbled one away on a punt return to set up a Marshall field goal. Here's another angle.
It's going to be hard from this perspective to reverse this because it's not clear. It's not unquestionable that it did hit him.
At the review, play stands as called on the field. First and 10 for Marshall. Cannot determine whether the ball hit the receiver's heel or not.
So Marshall will have the football, and Coach Schneider's team will go to work from their 13-yard line.
I think we'll get a large dose of Darius Marshall, his 14th start here, and they compare his skills to Ahmad Bradshaw's. Now he's in attendance here today, plays for the New York Giants with a year he had last year for the world champion Giants.
Cannon's going to go to the air, gets it into Passmore's hands, and he gets short yardage up to the 19-yard line. Robert Sands, the free safety on the tackle. They really set up a wall for Passmore to try to get something to develop on the far side.
Both teams with outstanding blocking by their wide receivers. Boy, you see Slate right there, and also downfield, that's Milligan blocking for Passmore. That's a Slate block right there. Milligan, number 23. You can see him in the corner of your top of the screen. Good blocking for Passmore. That's an art, a lost art. You don't see a lot of good blocking by wide receivers in college.
Pickup of 7, they say, just shy of the 19. Hand off to Marshall, picking his way ahead. He's hit, spins out of one tackle, and maybe a yard, and that's about it. Marshall runs hard. Sophomore from Milledgeville, Georgia. Called here. They'll send Passmore as the split end to the bottom of the screen. Slate in motion. Can Marshall hit? Breaks the tackle, and it's close. I think that second effort, that last lunge, got him the first down across the 24-yard line. Brandon Hogan, the sophomore corner on the play. Didn't get it by a whole lot, but they get it. The Herd will keep the football. Toss sweep left side. Marshall cuts it back, and he drives forward to the 26. That cutback ability there wasn't a lot available. He still picked up 3 yards on the run. Reed Williams was there on the tackle.
When they run that toss sweep.
Spot here on second down. Can flips it out behind Slate, and that's going to be ruled a lateral. The official marking it back near the 23-yard line behind Slate. Dangerous pass and well off the mark.
And, you know, it looks like you know, Cann's delivery, he's just throwing, releasing the ball a little bit high. He's not stepping into his throws and releasing at a very high point. This is why you have to step into your throws. This is mechanics. It can be worked on, but it's you know, a young player, and it may be a little nervousness, anxiousness, want to make a big play.
They've got a lot of big playmakers. They need a big play here on third and 11. And I think West Virginia might have jumped across the line. Cann's throw to the tight end incomplete. One at Slate. The flag back at the 22, it looked like Larry Ford, the sophomore defensive end.
Offside. On the defense, number 92. 5-yard penalty, third down.
So Renee, this makes it much more manageable now, third down and about six.
And don't think they won't go back to that matchup with Kent Richardson in single coverage against Cody Slate. It's a mismatch. So you look once again at that matchup as Cody Slate runs that sideline route. He takes the outside and just waiting for the pass. Nice throw, just couldn't bring it down. Could have been out of bounds anyway, but they'll go back to that matchup, you can bet.
Slate is on the line. There he is at the bottom of the screen at the tight end spot. They have three receivers, split right. On third and six, catch made by Slate. First down and more across the 45, and he rumbles to the 46-yard line. They go to Slate, who has been their leading receiver the last 2 years, Robert Sands on the tackle.
Slate with 66 grabs last year. This is a Jeremy Shockey kind of run, you know, right across this, drag right across the middle. Slate collects it in, breaks a pair of tackles, and into the secondary. He gets to the secondary very, very quickly. Again, 4-5 speed, outstanding speed for a tight end, and outstanding skills, and recognizes the defense quickly.
17-yard pickup. They go to the run game. The toss sweep to Marshall. Cuts it back and gets some positive yardage. Keeps the legs turning up to the 49. Looked like a short gain. He turns it into about four on that carry. You know, you've got a guy like Marshall, and then Slate and Passmore, they've got some weapons. You've got to know where these guys are. They can hurt you in a lot of ways.
You know, when Darius Marshall goes to the sidelines, he's replaced by Chubb Smalls, a little bit quicker, a little faster version in the backfield. But the guy you got to watch, and again, you have to scheme, is Passmore.
This time they go bunch set. Four receivers. Slate is in a slot now. They've got the tight end with three other receivers at the bottom. And Cann on second down. Goes to the far side, incomplete. One to Bryant Milligan. That pass a little bit too tall. Coverage applied by Brandon Hogan.
Good play by Hogan. And the ball was just to his outside, showed it had been more inside. I think he may have collected that. Calling for a third down, and Cann calls for a big play right now. Needs a big run, and you know, you got to think Slate will be an option. Pass more on a slant. Goes to open backfield, empty backfield.
Here's Passmore, the nation's leader in receiving yardage. Great speed. 2 for 4 so far today. Cann has protection. Zips it. It's tipped and almost picked off. Through the hands of Passmore, JT Thomas, a sophomore weak side linebacker, almost came up with the interception.
Ball arrived a little early. Passmore running right on the seam. A curl. And Cann delivers the ball. He was the first option. Passmore, he looked at him the whole time. And Passmore curled right inside the seam, almost intercepted. Incomplete punting situation. But he is getting bumped, and you can bet that is one thing that West Virginia wants to do. Just pound on Passmore, see how tough he is. Either step into the challenge or make him make plays when he's being hit on every play.
Case Whitehead gets his punt away from the 40. Jock Sanders calling for fair catch, and he makes it at the 4. Normally, you say let that one bounce. He opts to make the catch, 46-yard punt, and Case Whitehead pins him deep. And that's where the Mountaineers will have it. They have not had good field position through the first quarter, starting their deepest this series, and a handoff to Devine. A flag is thrown behind the play, and this could be coming back as Devine takes it out to the 10-yard line.
Holding on the offense, number 66. Half the distance to the goal, first down.
That's Selvish Capers, the right tackle.
In his ninth start out of St. Augustine in New Orleans. Good look at him right there. Former tight end at St. Augustine High School. Good basketball player in high school. His team won the national championship 1 year. And He was part of that.
You know, they've got a couple good tackles. Capers the more athletic at the right tackle spot. Stanchek on the left side, 37 straight starts. He's an All-America candidate.
Well, you know, you're going to see a couple of these guys. We talked about this in pregame, Trey. You're going to see perhaps in the next 2 years as many as 25 or 30 guys from both these teams playing on Sunday.
That was the final play of the first quarter. An interesting matchup here in Morgantown, West Virginia. A long drive for the Mountaineers to get on the board. Marshall answers, and they've got them backed up near the goal line. Second quarter coming up.